Hey, are you a DevOps engineer? You should really be working with Kubernetes and have a dev environment that you can run some tests on. In this video, I will show you how to use TeKanAid's free playground for Kubernetes and how to get that going so you can run your tests very easily without having to worry about your own workstation or laptop to run Kubernetes. Let's get started. All right, so if you are not subscribed to TeKanAid Academy, or if you're not logged in, go ahead and log in. And from here, you can go to all products, and you're gonna see a bundle for all the different playgrounds. So you can see I have a Docker playground, Kubernetes, Terraform and Vault, and Jenkins. So once you enroll into this free playground, then, or free bundle with all the playgrounds, then you'll have access to all of these. And then you can go to my products for sure. You'll have them right here. It will show up like that. And from here, go ahead and click on the Kubernetes playground. Then you can start this and you'll see the instructions and what to do. Very simple instructions. All you need to do is click this black button for the GitHub workspace or GitHub code space. Then create this code space right here. And if you're not familiar with code space is offered by GitHub. So you definitely need to have a GitHub account, which I'm pretty sure you would have. And from here, it allows you to create an environment, and that environment will give you a Visual Studio Code IDE and also a terminal. And in that terminal, you can basically run whatever commands you want. Linux terminal, you can specify two flavors of that Linux environment, two resources, a two CPU or a four CPU flavor. So in this case, I've ordered a four CPU for you, and you can see how this will run Minikube comfortably, and we can run all our tests easily within this environment. So a little bit more about code spaces. This is just a side note as this runs for us. This is a VM environment. So GitHub will launch a VM for you, and then you can run everything you need in that VM. Now, you can just run a vanilla VM and then run all the commands manually afterwards, or you can do what I did and automate the process. So in this case, you would need to create a dev container folder. And again, you don't need to worry about all this. I'm just showing you what's happening under the hood. This will automatically run a Minikube environment for you, and you're good to go. But while this launches, I'll take some time to explain what is going on. So under the dev container environment, there is this devcontainer.json file. And in here, you can just instruct code spaces of what you want to do. So there is this post create command, and we are actually in this stage right now. What this post create command does, after it creates the VM, it will run this command here. It's a bash script called startup script. We'll explore that in just a second. And then there's a post attach command. Now, after the post create command runs, this post attach command will run our Minikube start command to get Minikube up and running. Now, there are other features and configurations that you can do. I've also included extensions for VS Code like HashiCorp Terraform, also the Kubernetes tools extension. And you can also specify the host requirements that you'd like to have for this VM. In this case, we've asked for four CPUs, 8 gigs of RAM, and 32 gigs of storage. Okay, so that's really what will get launched for us for Minikube, and that's really plenty of resources so we can have a comfortable VM to run our tests in. So as you can see here, our post create commands have successfully completed, and now we're in the post attach phase where we are running Minikube start. So this is creating a Minikube VM for us. Okay, so I mentioned startup script.sh. This bash script is really what was running in the post create command. And in here, we're installing a bunch of utilities that are very helpful to run with Kubernetes. So all these are mentioned in the README file here. So you can see I'm installing kubectl, Helm, K9s, for monitoring kubectx to easily change your Kubernetes context, kubens to easily change your Kubernetes namespace. And I'm also adding a few aliases that I find useful. So K for kubectl, KGA for kubectl get all, KGN for kubectl get all with all namespaces, KDEL for kubectl delete, KD for kubectl describe, and finally KGE for kubectl get. Now, if you have other aliases that you'd like to see as well, just drop a comment in the comment section of this video. Let me know which ones you would like me to add. So you might have noticed that this Kubernetes Playground existed a while before, and that is true. And I was relying on Gitpod, which is another technology similar to Codespace. That is a company that also builds environments for people to run tests in. And the issue that I had with Gitpod is that it runs all in containers. So I had to have a workaround to be able to run Kubernetes in Gitpod. Basically, I was running a KEMU VM and then installing K3S on top of it. So it's a little bit messy, and it took over 12 minutes to load the environment the first time. So I wanted to get something a little neater and faster in terms of load time. So I opted for Codespaces. And you can see that our environment now is ready. So if I clear here, and let's make this a bit bigger so we can see. All right, now we can go ahead and run KGN, which will show me all my pods across, well, it's basically kubectl get all across all namespaces. I see that core DNS is not ready yet, that pod. I can show you kubectx to show you the ability to change context. Right now I only have one context, minikube. Kubens, I can change the different namespaces. So now I'm in the kube system namespace. I can run KGA for kubectl get all. I see now core DNS is up and running. That looks great. And what else can I show you? I can show you K9S. So this will show us K9S. If you're familiar with that and you find it useful for monitoring and for running commands across your Kubernetes environment, that works. So we can stop here, can clear, I can run Helm. You can see Helm is also installed and ready to go. And what happens is that this code space will run for an amount of time, I believe 30 minutes by default. If there is an inactivity or you've stopped using it, you are doing something else, it will stop the code space and you can always relaunch it. You can control all this by going to the bottom of the screen here, Codespace, and go to My Codespaces. This will take you to GitHub's Codespaces, and you can see the Codespaces you have right here. And you can run a few things here. You can open this in VS Code, your local desktop Visual Studio Code as well. Export changes if you've made changes here. Pretty much, you don't need to do anything other than just run your Kubernetes commands. If you'd like, you can fork the repo that I have here for this playground, and you can run Codespaces in your own repo as well. That is also an option. But as you can see, this took us less than 5 minutes. We got a Kubernetes environment ready to go to run our tests. No need to worry about your own desktop environment where you're running your tests on Kubernetes. Especially if you're on Windows, it's a little bit more challenging because you have to figure out whether to use VirtualBox or maybe WSL2 to get a Linux environment and so on and so forth. This makes it a lot easier. You're running the things in the cloud, and you can easily spin up this environment, destroy the environment, and everything is stored in Git. So that's the amazing piece. That's your single source of truth. So I hope this video has been helpful and you get started with running Kubernetes labs easily with the TeKanAid Playgrounds. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video.